Hello, I'm Bob Mary. I'm a longtime Washington journalist and publishing executive and author. And my latest book is Where They Stand, American Presidents in the Eyes of Voters and Historians. It's a book that attempts to put into perspective the question of how do we assess our presidents? How many do we have of them? All 44 of them. And how do we place them into historical perspective? And what I try to say is that the historians who are polled every so often and give their version, they represent a body of thought that is valuable, but it's not complete without an understanding of what the American people were thinking and feeling about their presidents at the time, the contemporaneous judgment of the electorate. And so I went back and sort of looked at the presidents in terms of how the voters were feeling about them. Therefore, a two-term president is usually more successful than a one-term president. And a two-term president succeeded by his own party, meaning he had two successful terms, sufficient, that the voters not only retained him after his first term, but retained his party after his second term. That is the highest praise that the voters convey upon their chief executives. And so I do a kind of an overlay. I look at each president, or not each in detail, but most of them, from the standpoint of the historians and from the standpoint of the voters. And what you find is that there's a great overlap, because the historians generally follow the voters in terms of their view, but not always. And that makes for some very interesting analysis. For example, why is Ulysses S. Grant, a two-term president, put in the failure category for decades during these polls? Now he's making a rise upward in the register, and that's probably more accurate. Why was Warren G. Harding, who died in office but presided over a robust economy and brought no problems to the country — he was wrapped up in a scandal, but he wasn't implicated in the scandal in any way, and it came out after he died — why would the historians put him at the very bottom? Conversely, Grover Cleveland is ranked relatively highly in these historians' polls. Eighth in the first poll, 1948, by Arthur Schlesinger Sr. And the fact of the matter is that he's the only two-time, one-term president. As everyone knows, he was our only president who has served two non-consecutive terms. And after each term, his party was thrown out of office. Once the first time with him on the ticket, and once after the party basically said, "We don't want you on the ticket." So they put William Jennings Bryan on the ticket, and he lost to William McKinley. So there are disparities that make for some interesting analysis and some interesting discussion, debate. Mark Twain said that it's difference of opinion that make horse races, and I think that's all part of this. The difference is that with a horse race, the difference of opinion ends at the finish line, but with the great White House rating game, there is no finish line. It goes on forever, and as I say in the book, want to play?